adjourned. I'm glad to be here, and I want to thank those that made it possible for me to be up there, my mom and pop. Say, did you know that talking about mom and pop's parents, did you know that if your parents never had any children, it's possible that you'll never have any either? And did you know that according to police laws, there's never, ever had a report that a woman shot her husband while he was doing the dishes? And did you know that about one out of every three people are just a little bit crazy enough? If you don't believe it, look to the person they're writing. Look to the person they're listening. And if they're okay, one out of three. I come over here tonight, and I know who I got in. I got insulted. Carol Thomas insulted me. She started laughing at me. What are you laughing about? She said, you look crazy. I said, why? She said, look at those socks. You have one title and one white. She thinks that's crazy. Huh, I didn't tell her. I would have her home just like it. Well, I sort of pity that. I sort of pity Carol. I really do. They're in such a dead business. I said to Tom the other day, you know his lifestyle, Tom? I said, I'd like to be cremated. He said, well, that could be handled, sure. He said, where would you like to have your ashes? I said, I'd like to have them sprinkled over Disney World. Disney World, why that? He said, I've never been there. Did you take notice that our Reverend Ronnie Haney is walking around on crutches? Now, we all know that he had a knee operation, but what happened to his knee? That we don't know, but I found out. And he said it was okay to tell you. It happened like this. One day, Ronnie was up in a tree, raking leaves. He fell off. Now he knows that too, because how would he get up in the tree? And where would they find a tree big enough to hold? No, you got the wrong idea now. He had nothing to do with that tree over the parsonage. That was sawed down. You know that these ladies out here that have this shindig going, they're smart. They're really smart. At intermission, they're going to give free refreshments. Now, they figured if they put me on the show, I'd upset your stomach so much that you wouldn't eat. I'd like to play a number for you, Gershwin's Rhapsody in Blue. Boy, I'd like to play that. I'm going to try something easier, though. I'm going to try Somebody Stole My Gal. If you don't mind, I'm going to sit down because I can't stand these jokes myself. Did you hear about the Italian girl? This Italian girl, they hired her to stump grapes. Got fired because she got caught sitting down on the job. Testing, coming through. We turn that on so I shouldn't start. The button on this side sounds wrong. Follow your question. Is the light on?
No.
Push me. Sorry about that. Try it again. Can you people in the back hear me?
Yes.
The people in front are glad you should talk to each other. Thank you. my old book, and I call it Songs My Mother Never Taught Me. Now, I don't know. I don't know if you ever heard these songs. The way they're written. Nobody leaves this boat until the mess is cleaned up. Here's the second song. I hear music and there's no one there. I see blossoms and the trees are bare. They took this guy away 3 o'clock in the morning. Next one. Born free. Her father's a doctor.
Thank you.
sheep that said to the other two sheep, it's got to be you. It's got to be you.
Thank you.
Okay, now. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Somebody asked me, how do you become a comedian? It's not hard. Anybody can become a comedian. You have to go to comedian school. When you go to comedian school, first thing they do is they fill your mouth with marbles. And you have to think,
how long?
Once you lose all your marbles,
I'm not going to be able to do that.
You sure?
Okay.
Thank you for your kind attention. Hello again.
Fascinating. It's good to see so many smiling faces, and we'd like to hear you laugh. Laughter's a good medicine, and if you look for it, you can find it every day of your life. At your work, play, home, school, away, no matter where you've done, look for it, you'll find it. Home. That's one place you can find laughter. What is home? Let's see. Definition of home? Home is some place where you can scratch any place that itches. It's really true, really. When I think about home, I think about my grandfather. He was an Indian, Chief Onawa. And he used to tell me about a certain fellow he had in the tribe, this Indian guy. He says, he just didn't know heads from tails. He just didn't know heads from tails. And he used to bring back the funniest looking scouts. The other day going to Lansing. Across from me there was a lady. She was dressed up real nice and had a big ring, a gorgeous ring on her finger. I couldn't help but admiring it. So I says to her, excuse me, madam. And maybe she was, I don't know. But I said, I can't help but admiring that ring. I said, I never saw such a big diamond. Well, she said, it's beautiful and it's very expensive. She said, it's a Plotman diamond. I said, a Plotman diamond? I never heard of a Plotman diamond. Well, she said, it's something like a Hope diamond. It has a curse to it. Yes, and I said, what's the curse to the Plotman diamond? She said, Mr. Plotman. There was a tough looking carrier right behind her. He said to me, hey buddy, would you like to see rocks? Look at that rock. Well, he had a big ring on his finger. I said, that is nice. Looks expensive. Yeah, he said, 3,000 smackers. Boy, that's a lot of money. But he said, I got it for nothing. I'd be getting it for nothing. Well, he said, my mother-in-law, she died, and she left $3,000 for a stone. Laughter's everywhere. Last week, we went to the mall, my wife and I, and while she's shopping, I roam around the mall and talk to these elderly people that come in there. Isn't that funny? There's a little old man, a little old lady, they're standing there at this water fountain where they have water, you know, dropping down into the... And she says to him, honey, let's make a wish and throw a penny in. He said, that's a lot of baloney. You just throw your money away. Well, she said, it's only 2 pennies. Okay, he said, if you have 2 pennies, okay. So she reaches in, she gets 2 pennies. She said, you go first. So he makes a wish and he throws his penny in. She says, okay, now I'm up. So she took her penny, she made a wish and she threw it in. But she leaned over too far and she fell in. And the old guy turned around, he looked at me and he says, I'll be darned, I didn't think these things work. Then there was an old guy sitting there on the bench. I sat alongside him. He says, are you married? I said, yes. He said, your wife with him? Yep. He said, you're lucky. He says, I have 3 wives. They're all dead. Well, that's too bad. Well, he said, the first one, she died from eating poisoned mushrooms. Gee, that's too bad. And the second one, she died from eating poisoned mushrooms. Then he didn't go on. I said, what happened to the third one? She died of a skull fracture. How come? She wouldn't eat her mushrooms. Just then I saw a woman and her husband coming out of the store and she was reading back. She was waving her arms around and she was giving him head. She said, I never saw anybody that was so ignorant and so impolite. And he said, honey, what did I do? She said, what did you do? She said, all the time I was arguing with the management, she said, you yawned 6 times. He said, honey, I wasn't yawning, I was just trying to say something. Then across the table, across the restaurant, we went into a restaurant there, across the table from us, there were 3 gentlemen sitting.
The waitress came up and she says, may I help you? And she said, yes. The first one says, I'd like a glass of milk. Second one says, I'd like a glass of milk. Third one said, I'd like a glass of milk in a clean glass. So she said, yes, sir. So she walked away. A couple of minutes she was back. She said, here are your glass, gentlemen. Which one wanted the clean one? Then there were two ladies sitting across from me there. And then, you know how everybody's talking about world affairs today? The one woman said to the other one, Elsie, what do you think about with China? And Elsie said, I tell you what, I'll tell you the truth. On a yellow tablecloth, it looks pretty. Then I took a stroll down the way and past a cocktail lounge there. There was two women drinking cocktails. The one just said, just finished her cocktail, she said to her partner, she said, are you having another? She said, oh my, no, that's just the way my coat's buttoned. Then you come to a machine there that if you stick a coin in, it would tell your fortune, and the other side would tell your weight. So I put a coin in. I got a card out. It says, you're intelligent, handsome, God's gift to the women. I poked my wife and said, read that. So she read it, and she turned around. She said, they got the weight wrong, too. Did you hear about this woman that she was taking a bath? And right in the middle of the bath, the doorbell rings. It always happens. So she yells, who is it? He said, the flying salesman. So she says, well, the flying salesman, what did it hurt? So she goes to answer the door and the noodles. She opens the door and the guy says, good morning, madam, where would you like me to put the blinds? She had a mud pack on her. She had her hair up in curlers. She had a nightgown on, drinking a cup of coffee. She looked out the back window. The garbage man was going down. Oh my God, she says, I forgot the garbage. She picks it up. She runs down. She says, hey, she says, am I too late for the garbage? He took a look at her and he said, no, just jump in. There was a German airplane, German airline. He was crossing the ocean. And he was having trouble. So the captain of the ship came to the communication center and he said, ladies and gentlemen, he is losing altitude. Do not be alarmed. Put on your seat belts and sit tight. I'll be back to you in 5 minutes. Thank you. 2 minutes passed, he came back again. Ladies and gentlemen, we are still losing altitude, but don't be alarmed. He said, listen to my instructions. All you what good swim. Sit on the right side of the plane. All you that could not swim, sit on the left side of the plane. Sit tight, I will be back to you in 5 minutes. Thank you. 2 minutes past, he comes back again. Ladies and gentlemen, this Duke of Schweinlund from the plane, he starts to put, and he's going to hit the water. All you that could swim, that's on the right side, when we hit the water, swim like hay. All you on the left side, thank you for flying the German airline. Something like this.
Sandman.
Yes.
Bring me a dream. Someone that gargles with strong Listerine. Someone that don't smell like cows in a clover. One thing I can't stand is underarm odor, Mr. No macho, please. One that looks cute in his BBDs. What's that you say? No such a man. Then for Pete's sake, send what you can. Oh, Mr. Sandman, please just send me a man.
For this one. About 50 years ago, they used to sing a song called I Have a 50 Cents. Does anybody here know that? I Have a 50 Cents. Goes like this. I took my girl to a fancy ball. Was a social pop. Stayed until the folks went home and the music it did stop. Then I took her to a restaurant, the best one in the place. Then she wasn't hungry. But this is what she ate. Some oysters raw, plate of slaw, chicken and a roast, sparagus, applesauce, and hard-shell crabs and those. And then she tried some oysters fried. Her appetite was immense. When she yelled for a pie, I saw an eye for half a 50 cent. She said she wasn't thirsty. She didn't care to drink. I had money in my pants, she actually made me think. Oh, no, she wasn't thirsty, but she had an awful tank. Listen, folks, I'll tell you just how little she had drank. A whiskey sling, a glass of gin, a glass of brandy wine. Gin cocktail, less of ale, and less of half a kind. She said she'd bring her folks around next time and we'd have fun. But when I gave the waiter my 50 cents, this is what he'd done. He broke my nose, he tore my clothes, he slapped me in the jaw. He gave me the price of two black eyes and with me swept the floor. He took me where my pants hung loose and threw me over the fence. Take my advice, don't try it twice when you have but 50 cents. That you're feeling lonely. Any old time that you're feeling blue. Any time that you look for laughter, let our fun night give it all to you. Any old time that you want some entertainment, we will try to make you laugh till you cry. Because we all love you so. Why, we even love your dough. So relax, let the rest of the world go by. Go on by, relax, let's get on with the show. Thank you. of dandruff. How do you like my suit? It comes straight from Paris, straight from Paris. Over there they call it the men's double-breasted sports coat. It has five pockets, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 2 secret compartments. Did you hear what happened last night over at the police station? Somebody broke in, and you know what they stole? They stole the toilet. That's all, just a toilet. No fingerprints, no clues, no nothing. Just the toilet. Now the police have nothing to go on. And he sent to Florida College, and I had taken up agriculture. So he came home, and he's college educated now, and so he said to Dad, how's your fields going? Dad says, they're coming fine, come on, I'll show you. So he showed him the fields, and said, yeah, Dad, that's wonderful. He said, what are you doing? Well, he said, it takes a lot of hard work, cultivating and all that. He says, I put lots of manure on it. So the kid goes in the house, he says to Mom, he says, Mom, thank you, Kev. Can you teach him to say fertilizer? She said, shut up, boy. It took me a year to tell him to make up say manure. I do a little inventing on the side. I'd like to show you some of the things I do to help mankind. Combination telephone and sweeper. Now the reason I have this is because the ladies, they like to talk on the phone and pick up all the dirt at the same time. Now here's something that you ladies have to buy for your husband when a gift comes around for a birthday, about the electric hammer. It's a real shocker. Here's one that you take notice to is a left hand. I call it the Pennsylvania Dutch calculator. It comes with a left hand and a right hand model. All you have to do is put your fingers in there and count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Subtract and take 2 figures away. Add the figures. You take notice there's a little ribbon around this. You take a finger there, that's a memory. You can buy a dollar at Kmart, $1.98. This past winter, there's this flu going around. There's a lot of people I noticed walking up and down Delaware. And they had these colds, their eyes were watering, their nose was running. They were reaching for Kleenex, and they run out of Kleenex, and then they say, oh, look at this. So I think I have it solved. Now this is what you call a white rubber. You wear this, and then when you have to blow, you just blow. Second grade, and they brought us a present. The teacher said, thank you, children.
I'm gonna make a game out of this. She says, I'll take a present, and you give me three guesses to see if I can guess what's in it. And the kid said, hey, that's good. So she picks up the first gift. There's a long box by 8 inches square, and it's from Susie. Now she thinks Susie's father is a florist. It must be a bouquet of flowers. So she says, I believe this is a bouquet of roses. So she opened it up, and it was a bouquet of roses. And the kitty stopped. So she took the next present, square box, put it about an inch deep, and she looked on it, here's Johnny. Johnny's father's in the candy business. So she said, it must be a box of candy. So she said, I think this is a box of chocolate. And she opened it up, and it was a box of chocolate. And the kitty said, yeah. Now, she picked up the third box, which was a little bigger than the shoebox, and this was from Mikey. And she thought, now Mikey's father, he's in the distributing business, sells soap. So he shook it. She saw the juice running down in the corner of the box. So she slyly wet her finger. Pepsi Cola. Yeah, yeah. He said, no, no. So she wet it again. Coca-Cola. And Mikey said, no, no, teacher. But she said, I got one more guess. So she wet her finger again. Must be birch beer. Nope. Mikey said, you're wrong. Okay, teacher said, Mikey, what is it? He said, it's a little puppy. He put his mind and swallowed it. Oh, my goodness. What are we going to do? He said, come on, let's call the doctor. So they called the doctor and said, what can we do? Our little boy swallowed the trunk of the bullet. The father says, doctor says, don't get excited. He says, it'll pass through. He said, what should we do in the meantime? He said, don't point them at anybody. And this little girl, she had a habit of sucking her thumb. And her mother said to her, honey, don't suck your thumb. She said, why not? Well, if you suck your thumb, you're gonna take in a lot of air. And what happens when you take in a lot of air? You're gonna get blown up like a balloon. And you don't want to be like that. No. So it worked. The little girl stopped sucking her thumb. A week later, they were riding on the bus. And across from them was a lady, and she was pregnant. So this little girl, she stared at her, and finally this woman says, little girl, she says, you're staring at me, do you think you know me? The little girl says, no, I don't know you, but I know what you've been doing. Sunday, Mother's Day, I'd like to recite a little poem that this little kid wrote to his mother. Little kid. Starts like this, he says. Every night when my prayers are said, who puts me into my little bed? And sometimes spanks me till my rear end is red, my mother. Who takes me from my little cot and puts me on an ice cold pot? And she makes me go, even the night cannot, my mother. And when the dawn, light of dawn has come, and in my bed I feel some, who wipes the tiny foam? My mother. Who dresses me in her son, my Sunday best, and then she thinks she'll get some rest. Oh, but in my Sunday pants I've missed. Oh, my poor mother. P.S. Dear Mom, I love you from my bottom to my heart, dear son. Thank you.
Thank you. Dick Hatchett.